Hello and good evening. Welcome to the Student Fashion Society Spring 2021 Virtual Fashion Show. My name is Alexa Rivera and I am this year's Student Fashion Society President, as well as a junior studying fashion and textiles at SUNY Oneonta. It's been a great honor and a privilege to help run the Student Fashion Society alongside my fellow e-board members and our club advisor, Dr. Chueshi. Dr. Chueshi has always been a great advocate for our club and has offered limitless help in guiding us to success and has always helped and encouraged us during these difficult times. Before we start the show, I would like to talk about the Student Fashion Society's role on campus as well as have my fellow e-board members introduce themselves. The Student Fashion Society's purpose is to gain a better understanding of the fashion industry. We are a student-run organization on campus that focuses on many areas of the industry such as fashion show production, event planning, public relations, advertising, modeling, and management. We've had many opportunities to talk with industry professionals, create fashion editorials for our magazines, and have design contests, and most importantly, anyone can join our club. As I stated, my name is Alexa Rivera, and I am the president of the Student Fashion Society, and now I would like to have my fellow e-board members introduce themselves.
Hi everyone, I'm Samantha Simon. I'm the Vice President of Student Fashion Society. I'm currently a junior English major here at Oneonta and I'm from Rockland County, New York. I hope you guys enjoy tonight's show.
Hi, I'm Eric. I'm a model coordinator for the Student Fashion Society. I'm a junior dietetics major from Monroe, New York. I hope everybody enjoys the fashion show this year. All the designers are amazing, so I'm sure the show's gonna come out great.
Hi, I'm Carla. I am a junior fashion merchandising major with a minor in event planning, and I am the Student Fashion Society's magazine editor.
Hi, my name is Lindsay Dichter. I am the set design coordinator. I'm a sophomore and a fashion merchandising major.
Hey, my name is Bree. I'm a junior. I'm a graphic design major and fashion minor, and I am PR for Student Fashion Society.
Hi, my name is Jillian Edwards. I am the beauty coordinator currently. I am from Monroe Woodbury, New York, and I am currently a junior with a major in psych and a minor in criminal justice. Enjoy the show.
Now is the time everyone has been waiting for. For this year's fashion show, we will have three scenes in the show. Our first scene will showcase the 2021 wearable art class collections. The second scene will be a small showcase of traditional ready-to-wear collections. And the final scene will showcase the spring 2020 wearable art class collections. I'm so proud to present all the hard work that the designers have put into their collections. These designers have dedicated so much time in and outside of the class to put together their garments, and I would like to thank them for all their time and dedication during these hard times to put on a fabulous fashion show. Before we start the first scene, I would like to take a moment to talk about the wearable art class. The first scene showcases this year's 2021 wearable art class. In this class, you learn about the design process by starting with the concept, which then turns into a final product that is focused on sustainability. Designers take already owned or recycled products and turn them into wearable art pieces that tell a story. And you'll see there's a story behind every collection. Wearable art pushes designers to think outside of the box and helps them to become independent designers. And I hope you enjoy these designer stories showcased in their garments.
Hi, my name is Jessica Barron, and I am a junior fashion design major at SUNY Oneonta. Today I'm presenting my spring 2021 collection, Reborn. This collection is repurposed and reused to give materials that would most likely end up in the trash a completely new life. The inspiration behind this project is sustainability, and I really wanted to use it as a chance to explore creative ways to make fashion more sustainable. That being said, everything in this collection is made from reused materials, either thrifted, unconventional, or from things I already owned from previous projects. So thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoy.
The inspiration of the trash bag set came from just thinking about how I planned on turning trash into fashion, which is why I mainly used trash bags as the material. I was able to machine sew the bags together, and for the corset, I paper macheted some cardboard and I painted it black as well as the strings, which I used to tie the pieces together. The paper bag set was inspired by all the daily waste from consumerism, which is why I chose shopping bags as the main material. I laminated them with tape before machine sewing the pieces together. I left the seam allowance on the outside because I felt it helped hold the shape better, and I liked the lines it creates with the black stitching and the way the paper bends. I also glued metal craft wire under the skirt to help with the shape. The belt is made from soda bottles, and I attached them with the straps from the bags that I painted black. I finished the piece by hand sewing the closures down the back. For my soda bottle dress, I was inspired by the damage done to our oceans from oil spills and other pollutants. To achieve the look, I cleaned and cut apart soda bottles, which I heated up with a hairdryer to make moldable, then I hot glued them together. I used the same large black trash bag from my first piece to create the lining, which I attached with hot glue around the edges. Lastly, I laced it up with different chains. For my ready-to-wear collection, each garment was inspired by one of the wearable art garments. I wanted to use similar colors and silhouettes, but I challenged myself to do it with what I already had and what I could find at the thrift store. The canvas set was inspired by the paper bag set. For the top, I used a canvas from the thrift store that I took apart, sewed together, and repainted. The shorts were made from a stained oversized jacket that I found at the thrift store. I took apart most of the jacket to cut and sew together the short pieces. I kept the same seam lines on the sides from the original jacket and the pockets as well. I altered the pockets to fit in this style garment, and I added black top stitching all over both pieces. The leather back blazer set was inspired by the trash bag set. I used a long thrifted skirt and a ripped leather jacket to create the blazer, and I attached the two materials with more chain. I also used a thrifted flat sheet for the blazer lining and as the base of the skirt. The top layers on the skirt were made from some thrifted curtains, which I gathered together. Scrap dress was inspired by my soda bottle dress. To create this garment, I used more thrifted curtains and scraps that I've been saving from this project and from last semester's fashion show. I had to cut up some of the scraps smaller so I could hand place them, then I sewed them in between the shell and the lining of the dress.
My name is Chase Painter, and I'm a sophomore at SUNY Oneonta. I'm very honored to get to show you my collection today. It consists of 3 wearable art projects and 3 ready-to-wear outfits. First, I will be showing you my wearable art collection. My collection is entitled Wonder. It was inspired by Alice in Wonderland, and it's about sustainability and how you can use recycled materials to create new and inspiring outfits or objects. I hope you enjoy. So, for my first outfit in my wearable art section of my Wonder collection, is a dress titled Off With Their Head. As I mentioned, it's inspired by Alice in Wonderland, specifically the Queen of Hearts for this dress. It was made out of garbage bags, playing cards, eyelets, red, black, and silver pink, Velcro, and then muslin for the base. I used hand sewing, painting, braiding, and gluing for the techniques of how I made it. For the second look in my wearable art section, the next outfit is titled I'm late for an important date. It's also inspired by Alice in Wonderland, but specifically the white rabbit for this look. It was made with muslin, garbage bags, red silk fabric, white and red paint, cotton balls, a zipper for the fastening, cardboard, boning, and sew-on snaps. I used hand sewing, painting, and gluing for the techniques. For my third and final outfit in my ready-to-wear section of my collection, this dress is titled Blooming Hearts. It's again inspired by Alice in Wonderland, specifically the Queen of Hearts again, and the roses that are in her garden. The materials are garbage bags, playing cards, muslin, elastic, and lace. The construction techniques I used are hand sewing, gluing, and gathering. I hope you enjoyed my wearable art portion of my collection, and now we're gonna go on to the ready-to-wear portion, which is inspired by the wearable art outfits. So for my first ready-to-wear outfit, is titled Roses Are Red and Black. Is inspired by Alice in Wonderland, specifically the Queen of Hearts, and my first outfit in my wearable art collection. I used black floral lace, red satin, red glitter tulle, and gold buttons, and then I used hand sewing, gathering, and machine sewing to construct the garment. For the second outfit in my ready-to-wear portion of my collection, this outfit is titled Running to Wonder. and it is inspired by Alice in Wonderland, specifically the white rabbit and the stocking outfit. In my wearable art portion, it was created using white lace, red satin, nude spandex, and white and gold heart buttons. And I used hand sewing and machine sewing to construct this garment. My third and final outfit in my wearable art portion of my collection, and my final outfit of my Wonder collection, is titled Adventures in the Garden. It is inspired by Alice in Wonderland, specifically the roses in the Queen of Hearts garden, and Project 3. It was made with black satin with red and brown flowers embellishing it, and I fastened it with a black zipper, and I used machine stitching for the construction. And that is the end of my collection. It is titled Wonder. It was very fun to make, quite challenging, but very intricate. I had a lovely time showing you, and I hope you enjoyed. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Akiva Johnson. I'm currently a senior attending Oneonta. I'll be presenting two collections today. First collection, Immodesty, and my second collection, Modesty. As for my inspiration, well, I was stuck in Oneonta pretty much the entire semester, so the idea or my inspiration basically came from attending or just visiting different thrift shops all over Oneonta. The ideas, they came to me in sort of a puzzle way, right? I saw the body as a puzzle, and I thought, well, how could I fit unordinary objects and materials all over the body, but do it symmetrically so that it could be visually pleasing, right? As I kept on going, different pieces came together and inspired me to go, wow, okay, this is an immodest samurai. This is an immodest butterfly. And I just ran with that idea, you know, because for my first collection, we have Immodesty. This consists of three pieces: the immodest butterfly, the immodest samurai, and also the immodest bag. As for my second collection, the idea came about as being modest, but in different variations also. The idea was to make it layerful, useful, and also comfortable. Not too complicated, while being complicated to put together in a way. As you'll see in a second. Each piece for my modesty wear is meant to be useful in many ways. As a dress, as a wrap, a scarf. It's useful based off how you can rock it, basically. It's meant to be experimental. And as for my modesty collection, we have the layered dress, the wing dress, and the neck scarf along with a skirt. And some of the various material I used were handbags, high heels, placement mat for the table. And well, here's my collection.
So you don't really like me?
You don't really like me?
That's your word.
That's your word.
And you gonna see true to that? Better stay true to that,
alright?
You gonna see?
No bullshit later now, Amy.
And you gonna see true to that?
Oh, I think she like me. I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me. I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me. I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me. I'm all in her mind. Shorty said she bad, she don't got no time for it. But she gon' throw it back on me and she gon' whine on it. Shorty, shorty, I heard you want me. Shorty, shorty, I heard you like me. I got you soaking like the ocean, it's that motion got me going. It's your motion got you soaking, yeah, yeah. Said that we can't be friends, I said it up to the end. Girl, you know that I want you, but let's not pretend. Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind.
Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind. Sugar plum butterfly, why you gotta do me, baby, like you did them other guys? Got me going crazy, crazy, crazy. You know I'm from the block, you don't gotta play me. It's your pretty face, really drive me so insane. They said it's lost inside, but I'm always here, right? Different hair every month, girl, I like to be surprised. Give me red, give me blue, girl, you're my butterfly. You had me going crazy in the drive-by, drive-by. Going down on my tall guy, tall guy. And you looked up in my eyes, girl, you really blew my mind. Had a step of saying why, why, why. Tell her why she cried, you say I ain't the guy. Oh, on me. I fix you up, you run your back. It's the same cycle, girl, you know I'm done with that. I'm done with that. What you want from me? Gave it to you all, you turned on me. But I don't got no animosity. Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind.
So you don't really like me?
You don't really like me.
That's your word.
That's your word.
And you gonna say true to that?
True to that.
Better stay true to that, I am. You gonna see?
I don't need no bullshit later now, Amy.
And you gonna say true to that? Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind. Oh, I think she like me, I'm all in her mind. Shorty said she bad, she don't got no time for it. But she gon' throw it back on me and she gon' whine on it.
Hi, my name is Jessica Andriaggi and I'm a junior fashion design major. And what I'm about to show you is my collection titled UFO, which does not stand for Unidentified Foreign Object, but Unidentified Fashion Object. I chose to name my collection this because I was heavily inspired by outer space and the artistry within sci-fi. I really think this whole collection just embodies what alien fashion would look like to me. I wanted it to be something that a person could wear, or alien, whether it be to an alien cocktail party or running some intergalactic errands. And this is why I chose to use both oversized and form-fitting silhouettes. For the color palette, I went with black, silver, and different pops of colors such as red, blue, and green, because I felt that this was most closely related to the colors you often see in a galaxy. And overall, all the materials were completely recycled. I didn't have to buy anything for this, and that was very important to me because I care a lot about the Earth, and even aliens know that we have to save the Earth. So I really hope you enjoy, and I thank you for your time.
You look bizarre in the apricot. You think that your space goes, you want it goes too cold. Now I go. I see the bruise, I see the truth, I see what he been doing to you. Put on the shoes, what's his excuse? He say doing some new kung fu. You said you kicked the booze, you know.
게 뿐. You know I'm just a boy.
'm a junior here at SUNY Oneonta, and I'm studying fashion and textiles with a concentration in design. The first piece is titled Retrocycle and is composed of gallon-sized and snack-sized storage bags. For this piece, I was inspired by snack time as a child. I realized at a young age that these bags we use for snack time were disposed of in the same garbage cans as regular garbage, rather than in the blue bins for recycled items. This has stuck with me for a while, and I hope one day we can move towards reusable bags and minimize waste. Similarly, my second piece, titled Decades, is meant to emphasize how much of our plastic waste may end up in landfills for up to 10 years at a time. Therefore, it would be incredibly beneficial to our environment to use reusable forms of containers. Much of New York City's population is busy balancing their social and work lives, so that is what these next three pieces are inspired by, the workers of New York City. Thank you all for watching, and a special thanks to Dr. Chiweshi for helping me along this semester and pushing me to do my best. Bye!
Hi, my name is Emily Legarry, and I'm a senior in the Fashion and Textiles major with a concentration in design. I love design because it allows for so much creative expression and the possibilities are endless. For this year's Spring 2021 fashion show, I designed a collection I'm calling Future Tense. I often find myself drawn to the iconic fashion trends that were popular in previous decades, so I wanted to take those design elements and modernize them, creating clothing inspired by the past, but that represents the future. The first three looks I created are wearable art pieces made from non-traditional, unconventional, and recycled materials to bring attention to sustainability in the fashion industry. All titles for my garments come from slang commonly used during the era of inspiration. Enjoy! My first wearable art piece was inspired by the 1980s, a time when bright colors and broad shoulders were totally in. I wanted a colorful palette of red, green, purple, and blue to match the wacky patterns and colors from the 80s. I love geometric shapes and lines, so I decided to create a dress out of panels of painted newspaper. I ironed on fusible to strengthen the newspaper and sewed together my painted strips, top stitching each seam. In the sleeve and bust area, I created open shapes with the newspaper panels, using little material but still creating recognizable shapes with the negative space. For an added avant-garde element, I flipped the skirt upwards to expose the underside and add some contrast. I used staples and safety pins to manipulate the stiff newspaper into the shapes I wanted. To complete the look, I added a crown-like hat created using the same method. For my next wearable art piece, I took inspiration from the 60s. Color blocking, mod styles, and short, shapeless dresses were all the rage. For this design, I used soda bottles and cans, and used only red and green colors to tie in the color palette from my first design. I wanted to push the boundaries of wide silhouettes, so I created a 3D diamond shape out of muslin. I then cut up the soda cans into triangular shapes and hot glued them to my base. I outlined each section with soda wrappers painted black to bring in the color blocking element. I used many pieces from the bottles and cans to create the upper bodice, like tabs, caps, and unpainted labels. For my final wearable art piece, I was inspired by the 40s, where everyone had a cinched waist and wide skirts. I decided to use blue and purple to tie in the two remaining colors from my first design. I pleated plastic grocery bags around the bodice and painted them blue with white stripes. To create a wide skirt, I used cardboard at the top and newspaper to emulate a cage-like structure. The skirt attaches to the underdress with snaps, making two outfits in one. To balance the wide bottom, I created a wide hat with matching colors. After using sustainable practices to create my wearable art pieces, we were tasked to create three ready-to-wear looks inspired by those wearable art pieces. Again, I wanted to incorporate styles from the decades I used as inspiration and also reference the design elements I used in my wearable art pieces to create something unique but also wearable. This first design was inspired by my 1980s wearable art piece. I wanted to use the same four colors, reference the paneling and top stitching I did in the first piece, and include elements of the inside being exposed on the outside. I achieved this by leaving my seams on the outside of the garment and serging or top stitching the edges to get clean lines. I chose a windbreaker and shorts for my silhouette because these pieces were popular choices during the 80s. I added clear vinyl panels to reference the negative space I created in my wearable art piece. The whole ensemble was made using vinyl fabric. For my ready-to-wear look inspired by the 60s wearable art piece, I knew I wanted to use the same color palette again and to also reference the wide silhouette. I created a form-fitted cotton knit dress as a base with accents of black cotton to reference the color blocking in the first garment. I embroidered green triangles along most seam lines to tie in the geometry of the cans I used in the previous look. I made a cardigan-like garment out of green knit mesh fabric with boning in the hem to make it stiff and create volume. I also created a sun hat out of the matching fabric to complete the look. For my final design, inspired by the 1940s, I wanted to create a tee-length dress out of the same color palette yet again. I wanted to reference the cage-like structure in the pleating from my first look. I sewed the flare dress out of purple cotton and sewed blue and white cotton and strategically placed lines over top of it to create my own textile. I extended the lines at the hem and the sleeves to give a small nod to the cage-like structure but still making it ready to wear. I created a corset-like piece that goes over the dress that was pleated down to the waist to give that cinched look but still nice volume at the hips. Overall, I really enjoyed crafting this collection. It really opened my eyes to what can be used to create fashion and taught me what I'm capable of. I truly feel that I combined the past and the future into a pretty cool collection. I also learned the true value of Elmer's glue. Thank you.
My name is Yulisa Velasquez. My major is fashion and textiles, and I'm concentrated in fashion design. And my inspiration for many of these pieces was a lot of my memories and emotions that I felt during COVID and the quarantine and everything that happened last year, mainly. Then I kind of gathered all of that up and I thought about some sketches, ideas, and stuff like that, and this is what I came up with. So I'm going to talk a little bit about my first piece that you will see right now. It's called Facing Reality, and I kind of chose the name because it was, I don't know, a lot of the pieces I kind of named them the way I felt during COVID. I felt kind of stuck, confused, and I was kind of facing reality. And, you know, a lot of things that we used to do, we can't do. So I guess that title is the reason why I named it. I made it out of playing cards. All of these pieces were made out of playing cards, and I kind of made a fabric in a way with packaging tape, and I would kind of put the little I cut it out, put the pieces, and kind of create my own fabric, cut out like the pieces you would make for like a skirt and a top. And I did it out of that. And then for the swirlies that I put on the sides of the arms, I kind of like just twisted the tape around and made it kind of the stay stable for the shape to stay. And I put a button, a clear button, so it wouldn't be too noticeable on the construction of the suit kind of that I made. And what else? I hand stitch certain places because it was very difficult to work with. And the architecture is really cool for that building, so I got mainly inspired because of that. And it kind of reminds me of like me looking out my window during quarantine and kind of wanting to go outside. But like, of course, we were very worried at first on what was going on in the world. And I thought about it and I kind of wanted to make a piece dedicated to that moment I was feeling. So color gel paper that was in the shade, like a green shade, emerald kind of green shade, and I kind of put that into the tape with the cards. And a lot of my inspiration came from stained glass windows from churches and stuff like that. My second piece, I called it Perception Prism. This one was a lot of work. I hot glue gun every single piece that you will see. I also used color gel paper in orange on the bottom. I got my inspiration from like tile work and mosaic pieces, because the back of the cards that I chose to put on my project was very mosaic like and it reminded me of like small tiles and stuff like that. So that's one of the main reasons I kind of made it appear like that. The third piece I called Celestial Helix, and the reason why was because I was inspired by a certain building in New York City and the architecture of it. So like kind of wanted to make it like same way I made the first one with the fabric tape kind of way that I made. And I put in cards and I also added the color gel paper in green and orange as well, both. And I added some purple duct tape as well to kind of add some color to it and create these lines on the top. So it kind of reminded me of like the panels, the window panels that you would see in that building. And the architecture is really cool for that building. So I got mainly inspired because of that. And it kind of reminds me of like me looking out my window during quarantine and kind of wanting to go outside. But like, of course, we were very worried at first on what was going on in the world. And I thought about it and I kind of wanted to make a piece dedicated to that moment I was feeling. So, yeah. Feeling so lost, taking you off. Now, boy, you know me well, said I'm that kind of feeling. Hope you enjoyed my wearable art pieces. The next pieces will be my ready to wear. For the first one, I call it Emerald City because I chose a very like emerald color, like a green tone, and I played around a lot with the structure. I tried to make it very structured like my first one, and I used like a green satin and the weight interfacing that I put inside to give it that structure in the front and the back, as well as this gold spandex fabric that I used to make the bandeau piece, and I used the gold binding for the bottom of the skirt. For my second piece, I chose Midnight Strikes
I named it that because the color really reminded me of midnight and kind of like night sky. I also did some like machine embroidery on the top and the side of the skirt that you will see in gold fabric, and on the top I did it with like the purple thread that I used for my last ready to wear outfit that you will see further on. My last outfit, I called it Plum Puzzle. It was hard to think about the shape, and I kind of played around with like the way it kind of fell into my body and the lines it created. It's not your regular piece of top that you would see. I kind of wanted to give it like a cape effect on the bottom, like long drape, like a jacket. And I used this eggplant satin color. And I also used the gold spandex for the skirt I made with it. And yeah. Early 20s to late 30s, and people who enjoy, I guess, having fun at night. I made this collection honestly like out of inspiration from the other pieces I made from the wearable art collection, and I kind of just wanted to play around with textures and color because I normally don't really enjoy color that much. And yeah, I feel like someone who really enjoys dark tones, I did use a lot of dark tones such as the dark emerald green, the blue navy, and the eggplant color. So I feel like someone who definitely likes dark tones. So yeah. And I really wanted to just come out and say, you know, it's really hard during these times. A lot of things like have kind of backed us up, and I hope that all of the other designers in this fashion show were able to create some magical pieces. And yeah, I'm really thankful I got to, you know, show my pieces and work on this as a personal designer. It gave me like a new experience, and I'm really thankful for that. And I hope everyone stays safe and sound and healthy, of course, during these difficult times. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Lan Xiaozhang. I'm a junior student at SUNY Eunyangta, and my major is fashion design. During the semester, I created 6 outfits. 3 are wearable art outfits, and 3 are ready-to-wear outfits. In the 3 wearable art outfits, the first one's name is Black Witch. My inspiration comes from some Disney cartoon images of witches. I use plastic garbage bags to create and illustrate the creative use of recycling. And then, I use the plastic shower curtain to create the second and the third outfit. Their names are Abyssway and Bloom. Scientific research shows that when people are in a bad mood, sweets can quickly make people feel happy, such as ice cream or strawberry cake. So I want to abstract these desserts into exquisite wearable art. The third outfit bloom is inspired by the blooming of flowers. I use brown and pink plastic shower curtain to represent the stem of the tree and the flower at the pink flowers. I hope this outfit make people feel happy when they see it or dress it. The ready-to-wear three garments are a collection that combines modern and Chinese elements. I choose red and black fabric, and the materials are polyester curtain and Chinese brocade. The first garment named Mulan. Hua Mulan was a great female general in ancient China. She joined the army instead of her father and to fight the enemy bravely. Mulan shows really strong women's power, so that inspired me to design a black jacket, but I think she also has soft and beautiful part. Then, I created a long skirt to match the jacket to express herself and strong. The last two outfits are named Brocade and Red. They are also half Chinese style. Chinese ancient buildings are my source of inspiration. There are beautiful red walls, green tiles, and vermilion paint in Chinese traditional ancient buildings, and I really like the kind of ritual red very much. At the same time, I blended the Tang Dynasty Ru Qun style in outfit 5, and the modern sleeve dress in outfit 6. These are my old collections. Hope you can like it, and thank you for listening. Please enjoy the fashion show.
Junior here at SUNY Oneonta. My major is fashion and textiles with a concentration in fashion design. Today my collection is called Waves of Abstract. My inspiration is just earth, water, and the movements of nature, as well as abstract paintings. As the process of making abstract paintings, I was really inspired just by the way colors and textures move together as the paint dries on canvas, and I wanted to recreate that in my collection. My concept is just to be cheerful and to show a love of life through my pieces. And the first part of my collection is wearable art with the purpose of being more sustainable, especially with my designs. The main materials I use were rice bags for the first three collections, as well as plastic page protectors and acrylic paint to create more abstract and whimsical designs. And the following are my garments. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
The main base structures for my following three garments are rice bags, as well as tape and plastic page protectors that were painted with acrylic. My first garment is called Blooming Orchid. The colors were inspired by this painting and the silhouette and neck piece from the structure of the orchid and stem. I used plastic page protectors on acrylic paint to create the vibrant reds and blues seen on the neck piece as well as the dress. Garment is called Greenery. I was inspired by the earth and the natural waves and occurrences of colors. I wanted the silhouette to be fitted at the bottom, but the top to have a very growing green style with bursts of color as well as movement from all of the acrylic paints. I wanted the decorations on the shoulders to look like a growing forest of moss and plants in a more abstract and artistic format. My third garment is called Bursting Purple. I was really inspired by jellyfish and the coral reefs. I wanted my silhouette for this dress to be less form-fitted and more organic. I wanted the flounces and layering to represent the coral reefs, as well as the movements of waves in the water. The structure of these garments were rice bags, and the colors and flounces were created with plastic page protectors and acrylic paint to make the colors stand out even more with the gloss of the plastic paper.
The next part of my collection is my ready-to-wear pieces, which were inspired by my wearable art pieces. For this concept, I wanted to still use those abstract styles and hand paint a lot of the flounces, but I wanted my silhouettes and my garments to be more elegant and more muted in tones and colors, but to still have that whimsical aspect. And I hope you enjoy.
My first ready-to-wear piece is called Muted Movement. I was inspired by my wearable art pieces, especially Blooming Orchid. I wanted to use a similar color scheme for the paint, but in a less saturated color tone with the nude satin twill fabric for the top. And I was inspired by the swirls of the abstract waves and paintings that I had shown before, and used that as my inspiration for the locations of my frills on the pants and on the top. My second ready-to-wear collection is called Spunky Skater. I wanted the silhouette and style to be youthful and quirky, so I hand-painted chiffon that I then pleated for the top. I created my own textiles for the skirt front by putting together black mesh, painted chiffon, and another layer of black mesh mixed together with binding at the end. The blue and greens in the chiffon are inspired by my second ready-to-wear collection, Greenery. My last ready-to-wear collection piece is called Emergence. I was inspired by my third wearable art piece, as well as the movements of waves and jellyfish under the sea. The detachable asymmetrical capelet is supposed to represent the movements of waves as if you're getting out of the water. I used mainly scuba knit for the attachable capelet, and for the black dress, I used a jersey knit to make sure it was form-fitted to the body.
In our next scene, we'll be showcasing some traditional ready-to-wear garments. These designers have created mini collections in garments that reflect their own individual styles, and the pandemic has limited many of the designers with the inability to access materials. But we are so grateful that these designers have dedicated their time to put together lovely presentations during the challenges we face. We hope you enjoy.
Hi, my name is Melina Montoya, and I'm a sophomore fashion textiles major with a theater minor. I only have one piece to present today, but I am very proud of how it turned out and all of the hard work I put into it. The jacket I'm going to show off is a culmination of all of my favorite things to include as a designer. Oversized pieces, shiny fabrics, complementary colors, and primary colors are my favorite things to play with. And this jacket just incorporates them all in such a unique way, and I am very excited to show it off. I hope you enjoy, and I hope you enjoy the other designers' collections just as much. Thank you!
My name is Emily Legary, and I'm a senior in the Fashion and Textiles major with a concentration in design. For this portion of the Spring 2021 Fashion Show, I wanted to show off a mini collection I'm calling Hodgepodge. These designs were created a few years ago when I was first learning to sew and figuring out what my design aesthetic was. I feel that those pieces we create when we're learning are often our most creative designs, yet they rarely see a runway because that's what they are, practice. Today, I'm showing off five designs that bear no relation to each other, besides the fact that they are a result of me exploring my creativity. Enjoy! This design was made using fleece as a base with felt strips sewn on top. I love geometry and stripes, and I just wanted to experiment with crazy colors and patterns. This design was created using leftover scraps of cotton. I wanted to learn how to be resourceful with my fabric and challenge myself to make a little bit go a long way. I also discovered my love for color blocking. This design is made out of outdoor canvas fabric. As I said, I love stripes and was drawn to this pattern immediately. Again, I wanted to experiment with mixing patterns and the direction of stripes. I also taught myself how to make buttonholes on this design.
This design was created in the flat pattern making class here at Oneonta. While the silhouette is simple, Dr. Altman had us experiment with embroidery, where I truly let my creativity take over and I found yet another aspect of design that I love. The dress is made from cotton and lace. This final design allowed me to combine creativity with biology. I've always loved science and anatomy and wanted to see if I could replicate an accurate human skeleton on a wearable sweater. The bones were made with lamé, outlined with felt, and the sweater is a cotton knit. This design showed me that there is no limit to what you can create if you have the right tools. I love being able to look at these designs and remember what I was learning at the time, learning about sewing or learning about my design aesthetic. These designs are truly the misfits of my collection of work, as they don't fit into any collection, but they do represent my journey to becoming the designer I am today. I hope you enjoyed my hodgepodge of a collection. Thank you.
This last and final scene showcases the Spring 2020 Wearable Art Class designs. Due to the pandemic, last year's spring fashion show was canceled, and many of the designers' hard work and designs were not showcased. So we're taking this time to show the stories of some wearable art collections. These designs were all focused on sustainability and brought to life through the design process, by starting with the concept and ending with the final product. We hope you enjoy the stories showcased in these designers' wearable art garments.
Hi everyone, here's Daniel Nguyen. I am a junior at SUNY Oneonta, major in fashion design.
This time joining the spring fashion show, I bring the collections named The Silent of Flower. What an evening gown, business suits, cocktail dress. The inspirations for this collection come from the Carnation Flower and Haute Couture collection from famous designers around the world. The main color of this collection is purple, yellow, and gray. All of the designs in my collection have a variety of cutting techniques to show off the beauty of a woman's body. This is my first design in my collection. The name of this design is Silent Number 068. This is the elegant party dress inspired by the yellow and purple carnation flowers. The main color for this design is purple and yellow. This design using recycled garbage bag to make this outfit, using the twist technique to make the shape of the flower, and using the form construction technique to make a form-fitted dress along with a nice bow at the back. Overall, make you feel like a princess when wearing this outfit.
When we fight like lions, but then we love and feel the truth. We lose our minds in a city.
This is my second design in the collections. The name of this design is Silent Number 039. This is the sexy and unique evening gown inspired by the diamonds, gray, purple, and yellow carnation flower. Using recycled warmer and garbage bag to create this design, also using the broken CD dish to create the visual effect for this design. Overall, we make you have the sexy but elegant looks. This is the third design in my collection. The name of this design is Silent Number 097. This is the Haute Couture evening gown inspired by the yellow and purple carnation flower. Also, diamonds are the other inspirations for this design, using recycled yellow and purple garbage bag to make this outfit. Also, using broken CD dish to create the visual effect. Overall, this is a really unique design. This is the last design in my collection. The name of this design is Silent Number 086. This is the sexy and heterocultural evening gown inspired by the gray, purple, and yellow Canadian flower. This outfit main color is gray. Using the recycled Walmart and garbage bag to create this design. Also using the twisting technique to create the giant flower garden on the shoulder of the model. Overall, this one is the unique design.
Maybe it's all that I've been through. I'd like to think it's how you lean on my shoulder. And now I see myself with you. I don't say a word, but still you take my breath and still the things I know.
This is the end of my collection. I want to send a special thanks to Dr. Chuishi because for always helping me during the time that I make this collection. Last but not least, thank you everyone for your watching and see you soon in the next fashion show.
Hey, my name is Kit. I have graduated from Junior Nianto in spring 2020, and I'm so glad to have an opportunity to join the spring 2021 fashion show. From now on, I would like to talk about my entire verbal art collection. Finished product made from recycled materials, such as wire, laundry paper, newspaper, plastic bags, and coffee filters, to arouse the importance of recycling. Knowing the texture of those recycled materials, sources of inspiration for data collection, and refer to the elements in it, thereafter performed by collage and sewing.
First of all, the design inspiration is from high-rise building architecture silhouettes. Focus on the silhouettes, the irregular shape, the high and low visual impact. On the top at the right hand side, the shoulder is higher and left hand side at the bottom is longer. Next, the design inspiration is from evening dress with the element of the Japanese paper fan. Focus on the silhouette. It's the teapot shaped dress. This design is inspired by the future immersion from humans, the development of AI robots, unthinking, magically manipulate body, focus on the color. The front is black and the back is purple. The cloth silhouette and the ruff make the garment easily intact. Last one, the design is inspired by evening dress with ruff, a modern style while missing the retro feeling. Focus on the silhouette, shell-shaped skirt, and a consistent color on the front. The entire collection presentation has been complete. Thanks for watching.
Alexia Rivera, and I'm a
junior fashion and textiles major at SUNY Oneonta. I'm so proud to present my spring 2020 wearable art collection from last year. It was my first collection I ever created, and it really pushed me creatively and to think outside the box. And I also love that the class focused on sustainability. It was a wonderful experience to see my own growth as a designer and to see these garments take shape. This collection's name is Celestial Geometry, and this collection was created to encapsulate a soft femininity, but also a rigid, sophisticated style with the use of geometrical lines and shapes. The name really brings forth this concept, as the inspiration of the sky influences the use of the blue and the white within the collection to encapsulate the softness of the heavens, while geometry refers to a more rigid aspect of the collection through the lines and shapes. This collection was inspired by both geometric rigidity and the structure that they bring, while balancing that out with the softness of the whites and the blues to help create an image of a soft yet fearless and sophisticated woman. I hope you enjoy my collection. This first garment is called Kaleidoscope. The garment was first draped in a plastic tablecloth to create a simple dress silhouette. Each paint chip used in this garment was cut into a diamond-like shape and then covered in a recycled craft plastic that gives the skirt an iridescent appearance. The plastic and the paint chips were individually sewn together and then glued onto the bottom of the plastic dress. I wanted to create a dramatic wide wing-like shoulder, and it was created by hole punching, gluing, and tying the paint chips together. This garment was created from recycled plastic tablecloths that were gathered to make the skirt and the train. Besides the train, the bustier has to be one of my favorite parts of this garment. I took scrap paint chips from the first garment and glued them to the drape bustier, and to add a little more interest, I added them to create dimension on the waistline. For the next garment, I draped a two-piece outfit from plastic tablecloths that included a bodice and a skirt. The bodice uses leftover paint chip scraps from my previous garments, as well as plastic squares I glued on individually to create a fringe-like effect. For the bottoms, I wanted to create a gradient using the paint chips, as well as create interesting shapes, textures, and movements within that piece. Each paint chip was individually cut, taped, and then glued onto the skirt to create the finished product. The next garments I will be showcasing are my ready-to-wear garments. These pieces were inspired by my wearable art garments that were shown previously, and this is evident through my color choice as well as the inclusion of lines and shapes. The first look created was rather a simple design that included a one-shoulder blouse and a pair of high-waisted pants. I wanted to use a variation of blues as I did in the wearable art collection, so when creating the pants, I combined a darker teal on the waistline, the lining of the pockets, and the back pockets to add some interest. A tulle fabric was used as an overlay on the bodice to add some texture, and a side zipper was utilized as a garment closure. In this next piece, I wanted to challenge my draping skills a bit more and create a three-piece outfit that included a vest, bodice, and skirt. Each piece was individually draped and then sewn together, again using variations of blue fabrics with white. This piece focuses a lot on creating shapes and angles. The vest creates diagonal patterns down the front and the back, and the skirt includes triangular shaped pockets as well as a smocking pattern that runs down the sides of the skirt, which was a very fun process. My third ready-to-wear garment features a royal blue jumper and a bustier that was draped. The jumper is floor length and features pleats at the waistline as well as darts on the bodice to make it fitted to the body. To add some interest, I decided to add a white bustier as a contrast to the dark blue. I took inspiration from my wearable art collection and sewed scrap fabric to the bustier to add more ranges of blues and add triangular shapes to the design. What I love about this design is how both pieces together really complement each other. For my final design that includes a bodice and a wrap skirt, I challenged my skill set a bit more. I played around with different fabrics and the way they draped to create a dramatic design. I used a satin fabric on the bodice to create a soft and elegant cowl drape on the back of the bodice. I paired this with a fun embellished tulle fabric to create dramatic sleeves full of movement. For the skirt, I individually cut each panel of the fabric into the shape and cut away fabric in areas where I wanted the blue to come through. The pattern was made by layering the white fabric over the blue and carefully stitching them together. This was by far one of my favorite designs and pushed my skill set as a designer.
hope you all enjoyed viewing my wearable art collection from the spring 2020 semester. I had an amazing time creating this collection, and it's been a pleasure to share it with you all tonight. Thank you.
Hi again, it's Alexa Rivera, and on behalf of the club, I would like to take this time to thank all the designers who took the time to design for the spring fashion show. Thank you for sharing your creativity and collections with all of us. I know it's been a very challenging year, and as students and as a club, we've had to adapt to these changes. And I thank the designers for taking time out of their very busy schedules to film in preparation for the presentation tonight. I would like to say a huge thank you to David Gizzi, who helped put together this lovely presentation, as well as Dr. Chueshi, who helped to make sure everything ran smoothly tonight. And lastly, a huge thank you to all of you in attendance. We truly appreciate your continued support for the Student Fashion Society. We thank you for being here tonight, and we hope you enjoyed the Spring Fashion Show, and have a great rest of your evening.